So Nathan Gray and the Scotland coach looking to get his side off to the best possible start with a win this afternoon against Italy. Italy coach Leo Epifania clearly looking for the same for his side as well. The referee this afternoon is Gerard Sutton from the... it's Todd Smith from the NRL. And it will be Italy to get things started this afternoon. Alongside me is James Graham, the former England forward, former St George and St Helens as well. It will be an interesting one, I think, this afternoon, James. Scotland have had that warm-up game. Italy are coming into this one absolutely cold. They'll be looking for a good start, both of these sides, just as we get ready for the 13 seconds of the everyone together movement to show there's no room for discrimination in rugby league or society. But it will be an interesting one, I think, this afternoon, James.
Yeah, 100%. And I think both teams are under no illusions that this is a must-win. If they want to play knockout rugby league in the next few weeks, they need to get the victory today with a group that contains Australia and Fiji. We saw what they're capable of yesterday. This is a must win for either team to play knockout.
Thank you.
So the 13 seconds observed. And with the hooter signalling in the background, we are ready to get this Group B encounter started. It's Italy against Scotland. It's a 2021 Rugby League World Cup, and Scotland get first touch of the ball, looking to settle things, looking to try and keep things calm, and just basically find their feet in these early stages, James.
Yeah, that's a great carry off the kickoff from Scotland. They'll be looking to just get through their sets and keep hold of the football as much as they possibly can. Obviously, Italy not had much time together, not had a warm-up game, so Scotland really, they'll look to take Italy into deep waters and bring the fatigue into the game.
Good drive from Sam Luckley for Scotland. James Bell now moving the ball forward. Driven nicely by both of the Italian props into the ground with the tackle. We saw Scotland last week in their warm-up game against England Knights, beaten by the England Knights, but they have had that game under their belt, perhaps a little bit more cohesion. We'll see how quickly Italy can also get to that point as well. Literally the first time we've clapped eyes on the Italian side in this competition.
That'll disappoint the Scotland coach, Nathan Graham. Not getting to the end of this set. They made plenty of metres in that opening set, but just couldn't quite get the kick away.
Way back, hold.
We see there James Bell just losing the ball with that contact. So Italy then with the possession.
James up, Marquez, hold.
Paratta at half-back along the lines to Brown. Brown manages to get the offload away. Hey. Moretti.
Yeah, hold.
Again, we've got Paratta. Brown again. Brown already. Oh, big hit coming in there from Sam Luckley. What a tackle that was coming in.
Yeah, Luckley read that like a book, and there's a bit of push and shoving going on. It was a great idea from Nathan Brown, but that's perhaps a play you'd want to use later in the day when fatigue is in, when there's fatigue in the legs. And yeah, just a great read from the defense there. It's a huge hit.
So Scotland then with the ball back, a bit of a loose pass coming out, picked up by Hayward. Manages to get the ball away cleanly. The referee wipes six again as well, restarts that set for Scotland. The pitch, incidentally, you may notice, might look a little bit odd in patches. It is an artificial pitch, as there's a mistake coming in from Scotland.
Yeah, it's again out of dummy half. The Scotland player just takes off there, and the Italian just knocks it down.
Will it be nerves in these early stages? So many little errors like that coming in?
Yeah, well, three sets now and three errors. So disappointing both teams now. Just need to get a hold of the ball, complete the sets, play the long game.
It feels like everything we've seen so far has been smack on that line that you can see there on your screen on the halfway line. Not too much movement either way because of the errors in the play so far. We've got an injury down in back play. One of the Scotland players just receiving attention. And that's Liam Hood about to come back to take his place, the hooker.
Yeah, he just strapped his fingers together. It'll be interesting to see if that affects him during the play in the remaining 80 minutes.
So Robinson now with the ball for Italy.
Move.
Brought down by Ken Lynette. Natoli, the centre at acting half. Gains a few more metres forward for Italy. Paratta takes his place once more to the centre of the field. Italy keeping it moving. Campagnolo driving forward there. Good offload. Almost half a gap there. The Scotland defence doing well to recover. And a quick play of the ball is looked for by the Italians. Brown again. Involved quite heavily in these opening minutes of this game. And it's Paratta again, going on the short side, offloading back towards the centre is Ryan King. A big hit again coming in, though, from Scotland. Luckily, once again involved there.
Yeah, twice they've come on the inside, and he's been hit hard.
So Paratta with a grubber kick through. That looks like it's got quite a bit of weight on it. Yeah, just goes dead inside, but the first real attack of the game from the Azzurri. Quick tap taken as well by Scotland, trying to drive the way through. Reacted well there by the defence. And getting
that's
to
great play from Buchanan. Just instinct. Realised the Italian teams have overchased there. Just quick response. Great work.
So Matty Russell playing the ball. Here we go from Lachlan Walmsley on the wing. He has had a great season domestically and for Halifax in the Championship. He's been a bit of a try machine on the wing for them. Now it's Logan Bailey's Brow. He'll be brought down. Brendan Sansi in there with a tackle for Italy. Once more, it's Hood. Hood to Bell. Bell takes a bit of a skip and a hop with that one, but the ball's keeping moving to Briley. He offloads towards his right-hand side, and Scotland really making inroads for the first time so far in this half into the Italian half of the field. Hayward keeping it moving. There's Bell. Bit of a skip again from the loose forward. Tries to hand off the defence. Still going. Looks for support. Can't get that ball away. The defence doing its job, stopping the offload. This is the last of the set for Scotland. Here's Briley. Good ball out wide to the right-hand side, but good defence coming in from Italy, snuffing out that attack.
Not sure what the referee's held the play up for here.
Walk back.
I think there might be an injury in back play, but Bell there doing really well. Plenty of involvements from both lock forwards, Nathan Brown and James Bell. Respectively for their countries. Lots of touches early doors. Bell with some great footwork. He's one to watch today.
Bailey Lou, the man upended by Daniel Atkinson, really properly lifted into the air with that tackle and turned. I wonder if the referee maybe just spotted a bit of an issue with that, but I don't think in the end anything's really been given. It's just going to be an Italian ball.
Nathan.
So the referee just having a word.
Okay, it's just late contact. It's on report.
Oh, he's put it on report, yeah. I thought it was close to the borderline of going above the horizontal, which is illegal in our game. So, yeah, the referee's obviously seen it that way and gives a penalty to the Scottish team. Great opportunity here for Scotland to mount an attack on the try line of the Italians.
So a great opportunity then for the Bravehearts. It's Luckley that goes driving forward, taking play to within about 5 metres of that line. Good work coming in from the Italian defence. Luckley just pushing them off, trying to get a bit of space to play it to Bell. Nice step from the loose forward, tries to drive his way through. Held up again. Will Scotland unlock this Italian defence at the first time of asking on their own line? Here's Hood keeping it moving along the line. Here's a chance for Scotland! Just held short, keeping it moving though out wide. The ball going loose. Did that go forward? He thinks he scores. Does Matty Russell, the referee, will be going to the video just to check this one out. Did that ball travel forward? No try. The decision given on the field.
I think there's an error in the build-up to this. It's going to be ruled a knock-on, I think. The referee allowed the advantage, but, yeah, I don't think this is going to be given a try, unfortunately, for the Scottish team.
Video referee to match director, we have a on-field decision of no try. Please can I check all available angles of the ball to determine the initial ground?
Video referee Robert Hicks this afternoon.
He has possession of the ball at this stage. Okay, I need to determine whether the ball is actually stolen as the player attempts to ground the ball for a try. Whether the ball was lost into the defender.
I think it's gone there.
I need something close in on the ball if possible.
To put the ball down, that loses it.
As he goes over, as he attempts to ground the ball.
It clearly goes forward. They can't give this a try.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, it's this initial ground I need to watch. If we go slow here, please. And whether that ball is lost or whether it's stolen. That'll probably be the best replay I'll get, and it's just to be able to determine that the ball is actually lost. So he's got possession of the ball. Yeah, I'm going to need it slow if possible, please. I don't need it at full speed. I need it nice and slow so I can determine how that ball comes out.
I'm not too sure why we keep looking at this one. Garn, for me, clearly loses the ball forward as he's attempting to ground the ball.
We've seen it three or four times now. That's the best angle I'm going to get. The white, the one from the sticks angle is probably the best one. But we'll take this one for now. Nice and slow. So he's reaching out to score.
Yeah. Perhaps they're just looking
there,
to see how that ball comes loose.
Ball, or is it lost?
But for me, it's Garn who's lost
slow,
it in the motion of trying to get score the try, reaching out. It's a responsibility of the ball carrier
there,
to maintain position as far, possession as far as I'm concerned.
Thank you.
There.
I've seen all the angles I need. And now
I think finally we have a decision. It's going to be a restart on the 20-meter line.
Yeah, still waiting for the decision on the screen to come, but the body language of the players suggests absolutely that it won't be a try. Well, I think we can tell. There we go, no try, finally shown on the screen. Matty Russell denied that early opportunity for Scotland. Having seen so many of the replays, I think, like you say, James, it was a question of how Garn lost that ball near to the line. As you know, did he knock it on? Was it reefed? That's certainly what they were looking for. And like you say as well, that even from the angle we're sitting at, looked a forward pass. But as it is, Italy. I don't know where I got Australia from there, but anyway, Italy with that ball, still 0-0 in these opening stages of this game. And a penalty awarded for a high tackle to Italy.
There's plenty of emotion in this game as well. You can tell both sets of players, anytime a foul play is committed, that players are running in. There's lots of passion out there, that's for sure, but just tempers need to be relaxed, I think.
Certainly the Italian coach, Leo Epifani, has been speaking to his players about the pride and also the history and the heritage of Italy, really trying to get that inside their hearts, I think, is probably a good way of explaining that, to really give them the idea of what it means to pull on that Italian shirt. A lot of the players qualifying through heritage this afternoon. So Italy now setting up a decent position on the field, coming inside the 40-metre area of the pitch, inside the Scotland half. Campagnolo moving it across the line. Good work coming in from Scotland. Parata waits at the play of the ball. Here's Brown. Nice offload to Robinson, keeping it moving. Italy with Natoli. Again, an error coming in, though, with the line there and space opening up for Richard Lepori.
Oh, that's a huge opportunity blown from the Italians. I really like that play. Nathan Brown playing with width, not playing sideways. He starts the play. It's a beautiful shift and really... Oh... He'd like that moment over again. Lepori, I think it is, with the line begging, just spills his chocolates. Oh, dear. A moment he would like back.
Lepori playing for Swinton in the English Rugby League's League One, promoted this year. He played in their promotion final just a few weeks back. Certainly knows where that try line is as well. As you mentioned, 12 tries in 11 games.
Yeah, and look, you know, opportunities are going to be... are going to be presented to you. You've got to take them at International Rugby League. You can't afford to bomb those chances.
So Scotland then driving their way forward. Good work coming in again by the Italian defence. Campagnolo in there helping out. But it's Scotland with that ball in hand. Hood towards the centre of the field to Luckley. Drives it in himself. Good straight run coming from the prop forward. And again, it's Hood to Hayward. Hayward juggles with it slightly, keeps it nicely. Here's Briley joining the line. Good offload from Briley. Briley with the seven on his back, playing at fullback this afternoon. And this is the last of the set, indicated by the referee. The ball goes to Hayward, who kicks cross field. Underneath it is Robinson, takes it beautifully for the Italians. And what did you make of that kick on the last there, Graham? James?
Yeah, look, it was under a lot of pressure, and that'll please the Italian side. Doing those little effort areas, putting on the kick pressure, it makes such a difference, so it really affects the ability for Scotland to turn this Italian team around. Great kick pressure from the Italians.
Six again indicated by the hooter. Brendan Santi, the man in possession for the Italians.
Hold.
Once again, Parata bringing in the winner, Mason. He's brought down. Derek Mason from the Sunshine Coast Falcons. And now the Italians move the ball out towards the right again with Brendan Santi, one of the most capped players in this squad. 19 caps, two World Cups for him previously. As Parata goes, little ball to Robinson. Robinson, nice ball to Natoli. Natoli's got half a gap, bit of daylight support as well with him. Good tackle coming in from Garn from Scotland as Italy now looking to keep that momentum going. Moving it with Brown. Brown trying to pick up the pace. Met by Luckley. The tackle comes in from Scotland. This is the last of the set. Parata assessing his options. Ball comes out to Iaria, keeping it moving to Robinson with a chip through. Chased as well. Will it be not clear? Will it be touched by the Italians? The referee raises a hand, goes to the video, and the Italians think they've scored.
I think they have as well. It twice now they've come down this right-hand side and created opportunities. They didn't quite finish it off, but they remain patient. They move the ball back to the left. It's a great kick.
Video referee to match director, we have an on-field decision of a try. Please can I see all available angles to determine the grounding, please? It's from a kick, so can we start with the ball paused on the foot from the kick? All players on the right are onside. We can go on from here, I think. Thank you. Just run it through to the grounding now, please. Players on the right of the key. So, yeah, that's going to be the right angle. Just nice and slow on that, please, if we can. It looks like he brings the ball down on that angle. The first angle that you showed me, the grounding, will be the right one. Nice and slow, please. Determining that the ball is actually taken to ground and in the field of play. The angle from the corner camera is the best angle to determine it, and if we can go slow, that'll be the perfect one. Slow, please. Slow. In possession. Thank you. I've seen all the angles I need, and I've now made my decision.
So everyone looks happy with that, waiting for the decision to come through. We get there with the try from the fullback, Luca Polselli, winning the race to touchdown from the grubber kick through, and it's first blood to the Italians.
Yeah, great finish from Polselli there. He had work to do. He didn't have much room to work with, but that's that determination to get the ball down. And like I said, the Italians having plenty of joy down this right-hand side. That's an area of concern for me. So Coach Nathan Graham will want to get onto his left edge, because twice now the Italians have come down there and made inroads. But it's a great finish on the back end of a beautiful kick as well.
The kick coming through from Radin Robinson, a late call-up into this squad as well. He's certainly just shown why he should have been on the plane, I think, to come for this World Cup. And it's Jack Campagnolo with the kicking duties this afternoon for Italy. The wind that's been howling a little bit around here has dropped recently, making kicking conditions a little easier as the touch judges' flags go up and indicate the successful attempt for Jack Campagnolo, and Italy take a 6-0 lead.
Yeah, and just looking at this try again from Polselli, it's a very brave effort there, so it's easy to see that you're about to go into the advertising boards there, and you've got to make a decision. He wants to get on that ball first, and very brave to get that ball down over the line, and first points for the Italians.
So Scotland restart the game then. Italy with the upper hand from the early stages, from that opening try. And their tails will be up from that, driving forward. From the acting half again, Parata bringing in Brendan Santi. Santi met by Sam Luckley again, and also James Bell from Scotland. As Italy try and drive their way up the centre of the field. And they've had a bit of success so far driving up the centre. Nathan Brown particularly, just adding that little bit of an injection of pace.
Yeah, that's right. Nathan Brown's had plenty of touches, lots of action. 2 weeks ago to the day, he was playing in the NRL Grand Final, and here he is again with a great, strong carry. Great work from the Italian 13 there, and this is a brilliant set after point, and Brown is still going. Not so sure if the tackle was held there.
Either way, it's the last that had already been given by the referee. The kick is high. It's taken nicely by Lachlan Walmsley, the winger, and Scotland have the ball back. But what a drive coming from Nathan Brown.
Yeah, it was an outstanding run, wasn't it? I thought he was still going. So he played the ball. It's and like I say, a great set after points. They'll be really pleased with that. Got to the end of their set and a great kick on the end of it too.
Taken well by the winger as Scotland try and make yards to get outside their own half of the field. Kieran Buchanan once again, brought down by Brown and Parata.
Last tackle, Dean, release
Scotland
the
again, already onto the last of their set.
Not late.
Hood with the ball along to Hayward. Hayward kicks downfield, goes over the head. Oh, what an awkward bounce. That one is picked up eventually by Paul Selly.
Well, that's it. That's interesting, isn't it? That's what playing on an artificial pitch can do. I'm not sure how many of these players are used to playing on this surface, but that's the rugby league. A rugby league ball is difficult to judge at the best of times, but on this surface, it makes it even more difficult. And we saw a really wicked bounce of the ball, so that's a lesson for the Italians back three. Don't let this ball bounce unnecessarily.
So as Italy keep driving the way forward, Scotland having to work in defence. Just briefly to mention about the pitch, this ground here is the home in the English Championship of Newcastle Thunder. So there's a lot of rugby league played on this ground, and you do hear coaches saying sometimes they rest players because it takes it out of their knees as a kick comes over the top from the Italians. Again, taken nicely by Walmsley on the wing for Scotland. Great chase by Sansi. I think that was high, though.
Yeah. Just caught him around the head. He puts his hands up and apologises. A penalty nonetheless.
Yeah, he nearly took his hair off, never mind his head, just absolutely went for the curls. You could, his face there, the impact, you could see it coming in. I think he could see what was going to happen before Santi hit him there. The way you're chuckling, I get the impression you've been in that pitch situation yourself a few times.
Santi's got plenty of hair, so he doesn't need to steal off anyone else, that's for sure.
So Scotland then in possession from that penalty.
Okay,
just outside their own 40 metres. Here's Bell to Luckley, getting through some good work for the Scots in these early stages, but a loose carry. But a penalty. Did you think he got off lightly there?
Yeah, the referee's called the strip. I'm not too sure if the Italians will look for the captain's challenge. They've decided against that. I think that's a tough call on the Italians. No, clear as day. He's reefed that one. Not what the Italians needed. They've played well. It was a great set after points, and then they've just given away two penalties on the bounce, just inviting pressure. Inviting pressure in these opening stages, not needed at all.
So let's see what Scotland can do with this then, coming into the Italian 40.
Right here, Brendan.
Hood again to Hayward. Hayward keeping it moving to Bell. Met by his opposite number, Nathan Brown, in there with the tackle. The Italians at the moment, to say this is their first run out, have looked pretty steady in this opening 15 minutes. There's another penalty awarded for Scotland.
Yeah, again, discipline letting the Italians down. It's Bell and Brown going up against each other, both key players for their teams, but Brown just all over the face of Bell there. An ill discipline. This could cost the Italians three penalties on the spin. It's just not what they needed. It's all self-inflicted, and they're just inviting pressure.
We see again the challenge on Bell. Yeah, you see
Brown's all over him there. That's a penalty. He's lucky not to get himself in the sin bin for the attention he's given Bell there.
Okay, let him up. Give space.
So Scotland electing to run this from the penalty. Here's Parata, Hood from acting half. Away to Hayward. Hayward dances his way through, almost saw half a gap. That was closed by a wall of blue shirts. Once again, it's Bell to Gahn. Gahn, nice little ball there to Lynette.
Okay, get up.
Brought down just short of the line now. Best pressure here from Scotland of the game so far. Hayward takes on the line, keeps it moving to Briley. Long ball out wide, finds Walmsley. Walmsley tries to go himself. The Italians have work to do in defence, and the ball comes loose. The referee says it was reefed again. And the Italians' discipline at the moment, just letting them down.
Yeah, another penalty on their own goal line. It's great scramble, and it's just unnecessary. They did all the hard work here. Walmsley's going for the line there. they're in total control of that tackle, get the defensive line set, and just a poor decision to reef the ball away.
I think Scotland thought they'd scored there as well until the referee blew the whistle. Nathan Brown just questioning one or two things by the looks of things, having a good old word with the referee.
It's the what they call over in Australia the Harbour Bridge pass from Brierley there. A good option because the Italian defence had jammed up, which creates the opportunity to throw that ball over the top. It's a pass I would never like to throw myself, but if you've got the skills to do it, it's a thing of beauty to watch. Look to see more of that as that Italian team gets very aggressive on the edge there, but that you do leave yourself open to that style of ball, and Brierley's the type of person that can pull it off.
And certainly that pass taken nicely by Walmsley, who had work to do, almost bending backward, arching backwards as he took that out of the air. So play will continue after that stoppage. And it's the Scots again to tap that ball and get things going once again. Bell with a very straight direct run up the centre of the field. Again, bringing play inside the Italian 10. Hood once again, keeping it moving to Garn, brings Lynette inside.
Great contact from the Italian defenders there, brilliant stuff.
Garn looking lively now with the ball in hand in the middle of the field, taking on the line himself, drives in, the tackle coming in from Antoni Aria.
Get to the line, hold, go, three.
Hood again. Nice chip coming through, it rebounds off the defence though, and it's scooped up gratefully by Ethan Natalie.
More pressure for the Italians though, they've knocked that one on, it's difficult. But the Scots will get an attacking scrum in the centre of the field. Let's see how they shape up. They'll look for a formation, look for a set piece play that they'll have worked on all week at training.
Neither of these sides will have had too many training sessions ahead of this opening game, just because of the nature of squads coming together at the end of the seasons and players coming from all around the world to gather in both of these squads. So let's see what the Scots can manage now. From the base of the scrum, nicely out wide to Brierley. Brierley trying to find his way through, closing again that gap. The Italian defence. Hood to Hayward. Bringing in Luckley. Luckley will do the hard yards. Gaining a few more metres forward.
Release!
Here we go again with the Scots. Logan Bailey's brow taking play close. Is he over that line? He's held up, says the referee. Scotland really pushing that Italian defensive line, but still coming away with nothing. But the Scots at some point really will be looking for this pressure to make some difference.
Yeah, and it'd be interesting to see just how much it takes out of the Italian team. Like we said, this is their first run out in a long time, and doing this sort of defensive work pays a price later on, usually.
So Hayward, ball in hand, looks again for that loopy pass, intercepted this time by the Italians, and Scotland's chance just breaks down. I'm tempted to say they almost threw that chance away there, James.
Yeah, it's unfortunate they've spent a lot of time down here, but it's a huge let-off for the Italians. Ill-discipline and then a mistake, but they let off the hook and they'll get back into this game now.
See again there, that ball going high, scooped up by Jake Mason out of the air from Bailey Hayward. So it's Italy with that possession. Italy have never got out of the group stages of the World Cup from their previous appearances. And this is on the last. The kick comes long downfield. Ryan Brierley goes back there. So is Matty Russell. And it's Russell that takes that ball for Scotland and goes towards that line. Natalie in there with the tackle again. Another big hit coming in there. It was Richard Lepore this time, the man who made that initial contact.
It was a great clearing kick from Campagnolo there for the Italians. He really got them out of trouble and saved their set with a huge boot.
Walmsley coming in the middle of the field looking for work.
I like Walmsley, I like what he's about. He's very busy in there, he fights every time he's in the contact, fighting to play the ball quick for his team.
Buchanan gets to his feet and plays the ball. It's to Garn, who's looking lively. More lively as this half goes on. Keen there to get this ball played on the last of the set for Scotland. And it's Hood that puts the chip through, he's chased it, he's picked it up himself, and he looked to get it away. He'd got the man outside him.
Oh, it was Russell, he was open, he just couldn't quite get the pass. It was inventive stuff though, it was a quick play of the ball and a beautiful little kick. Oh, Hood just couldn't get that ball away, could he? That's better from the Scots though. They actually created something that time in that set. They've just got to keep going, keep asking questions of this Italian defence.
Credit there to Luca Polselli, I think, as well, for the tackle that just prevented that pass from coming out too.
Yeah, he was quick. He was quick to react. He didn't give any Hood any time or any space, and that's what made the decision for him. It was great work from the Italian fullback, Polselli. Here's Brown again. Plenty of action early for the Italian lock forward.
Yeah, he's certainly been instrumental so far, I think, in the pace that Italy have tried to find in their attacking play. So it's Scotland, I was going to say, having to defend, but it's Scotland now found guilty of ripping the ball from the tackle, giving Italy some easy yards upfield. And we'll see how far they've piggybacked, basically, as a result.
Yeah, and obviously, we spoke about it earlier in the piece, the Italians not really having any game time together, but they'll take a lot of confidence out of the early try line defence that they've had to do and the opportunities that they've created as well. Obviously, they've had a big week in training, and it's showing up. We're seeing it here today.
So the kick downfield, gaining them some nice yards, and a quick tap is taken by Daniel Atkinson. Tries to scuttle forward before the tackle comes in. Here we go again with Brown. He brings the area in. Good metres gained by the prop. And it's Parata again to Brown, right up the centre of the field. He's running that same channel every time, straight and direct up the middle. And when he hits that defensive line, he's taking two or three defenders with him every time. Here's Parata.
Nathan.
To the centre of the field. Drive coming forward. And Italy really now pushing that line. Here comes a chance. And it looks like Italy have got their second of the game through Dean Parata, the hooker. And Italy are in. They've scored again.
Yeah, after doing three or four defensive sets on their own try line, they get a piggyback penalty. And it's just a simple, quick play the ball. Plays what he sees, Parata there. He sees the opportunity, it's straight through the middle. And it's a brilliant finish from the Italian dummy half there. Bell just clocking off. Lazy, tired defense from Bell. Parata just says, thank you very much. The ball in two hands as well, which creates a decision to make for the Scottish defence, but they're just far too wide at a defender there. Luckily, just given that opened up the gap, he needs to be tighter in there and close down that opportunity. Fundamental basics there from the Scots, just not getting it right, and the Italians have taken everybody by surprise with their start to this tournament. It's been a great opening 20 minutes or so for this Italian team. Lots to like about what they're doing.
And how quickly it turned around from Scotland going so close and having two or three sets on the Italian line. One play move later as such, straight up the field with that penalty, bang, Italy score.
Yeah, we see it so often in our sport, don't we, where teams just countless pressure and they can't get the result. Then the team gets the ball on their first set, they go up the other end and score a try, probably against a run of play, but you know, it's brilliant from the Italians. They'll take a lot of confidence from their work in defence, holding out this Scottish team. And yeah, if they're taking opportunities like that through the middle, they create opportunities on this right-hand side. It's been a great performance so far.
Campagnolo right in front of the post, making no mistake, adding the extra two. 12 points to nil. Italy have that advantage. And I'm sure their coach, Leo Epifania, will be delighted. You see again, Dean Parata just getting around, luckily, and stretching out. Putting that ball down right underneath the post. We see Leo Epifania in the centre of your picture there, just slightly hidden behind the screen as Scotland restart play again. Taken by Robinson. Moretti. Some pace coming in from the forward there.
That's a big run off the kickoff from Moretti. I like what he's done so far in this game today. He's worked tirelessly so far. He'll earn his rest when he gets one soon.
So Italy, again, with Santi this time. Good, strong run from the forward. Plays for Keithley Cougars, another side that's just been promoted from League One to the Championship. Brown. Brown's pulling the strings, isn't he?
He sure is, and alongside Moretti and Liara as well. Lots of action so far. Plenty of tackles, plenty of work rate. That's a great kick as well. How good's the chase? The Italians are down, they're up for this, but talking about the middle three forwards of the Italians have worked really hard, plenty of high numbers in both defence and attack.
Matty Russell in off the wing for Scotland, taking that ball in, met again by that wall of blue. Both the walls are blue, but clearly different shades of blue. Scotland, the deeper, the navy blue. Italy in the more traditional blue that you think of when you think of their football team. And here goes Bell now for Scotland. Not a clean play of the ball, but play on, says the referee, as Hayward has ball in hand. And yeah, Scotland keep it moving.
They're looking a little bit clunky, the Scots, at the moment. They just need to find their rhythm a little bit. They'll be shell-shocked here, being two scores down so far.
Interesting for Scotland, that run-out they had against the England Knights last week. They had Ryan Briley in at half-back, so I wonder if that's had a little bit of... a bit of an impact on their player this afternoon. Briley joining the line beautifully from the full-back position, but they've not played with him in that position yet, of other in training. So the kick is high. It's hacked back in field by Walmsley from the wing. Italy pick it up. But I think Walmsley there doing the best he could and almost pulling something out of the hat with it, I think.
Yeah. Walmsley using his feet there. Not something we've seen very often. It's inventive stuff from the Scottish winger.
So Italy now going forward with Atkinson.
That's a great run from Atkinson there.
Just as we see Lachlan Walmsley. I think he'll be signed up for the Scottish football team by the look of the skill he pulled out with that one. So here we go again with Bell. Brown up the centre of the field.
He's done that little inside play again. He's looking lively for that. He's keeping the Scottish defenders honest.
Here's Moretti. Bit of a gap opening up in that Scottish defence. Keeping it alive to Campagnolo. Moving out to Ryan King. King drives his way forward. This is the last of the set inside the Scottish 40. The ball in the hands of Campagnolo. That will beat Walmsley, or will it? Will it find touch? It does just find touch, just the right side of the corner flag. A nice kick coming through on the last.
Yeah, I think he would have liked it to stay in play, but it's not the worst result in the world for the Italians. They keep the Scottish team pinned in their own half.
And Walmsley just shepherding that ball safely into touch. And it's Scotland that come up and away for the first time of this set with ball in hand. Good run there coming in from Russell on the wing.
That's an outstanding run from Russell. Really gets a set going. Backed up by Walmsley now.
Both wingers from Scotland really starting to come into the middle of the field, hunting for work early in their sets. As play now comes towards the halfway line. Italy now, the team having to defend. A quick play, the ball is urged by Schneider, who's on off the bench. Keeping it alive nicely, back in the hands of Schneider. And Scotland gain the extra few metres as a result. This will be the last. Again, the referee raises his left arm. And the ball's with Hayward. High kick over the top of the defence. Taken cleanly, though, by Lepori. No danger at all there for Italy. And the winger comes forward and just brings play outside of the Italian 10. So Scotland now having to defend. They'll be keen to keep the Italians pinned at this end of the field. But Italy certainly have had the better of the go-forward so far.
Yeah, absolutely. And Scotland just look a little bit clunky in attack. I'm not really too sure what they're trying to do. They don't really seem to have set up any attacking shape and thrown options. They are starting to get some offloads, but they don't know how to capitalise on it.
Robinson with ball in hand for the Italians, hauled down by his shirt collar by Kane Lynette. So Italy shifting the ball back towards the centre of the field. Campagnolo again with that high kick. Taken, not taken by Briley. Definitely not taken by Briley. Just manages to scoop that possession in safely.
Yeah, it's that floating spiral bomb of Campagnolo causes any fullback in the world trouble. And Briley, he struggled with that one twice. It's a great kick from Campagnolo, though. Expect to see more of that this afternoon. Now he's tested Briley out. He can be expected to see some more of those style of kicks later in the piece.
Briley been playing at fullback for Salford this season in the Super League. Also can, of course, operate at halfback as well. Here goes Scotland once more with that big drive through coming from the captain, Dale Ferguson, on off the bench. Again, a man with many caps to his name, and this time winning a penalty as well for the Bravehearts.
Yeah, the Italian players, they're just stealing the ball. There's three in the tackle. You just can't do it. And as well as the Italians have played, ill discipline has let them down, and they're just bringing more work for their forwards to do. Guys like Brown, Moretti, Liara all working hard. The Italians can't afford to be as ill-disciplined, because if the Scots get it right, they will score points, and they're just inviting pressure, unnecessary pressure as well.
So Bailey Hayward with the kick for touch. I don't know if you could hear the whoops in the background then as that happened. I don't know whether somebody in the crowd had a bit of a near miss with the ball or not. I'm not sure. But back on the field, it's Scotland in possession. Schneider at acting half to Garn. Garn to Ferguson. Ferguson bringing play to just outside the Italian 20. Schneider to Hayward. Hayward keeps it moving out towards the right-hand side. Finds Aitken. Aitken looks for support. He won't get it because, again, that Italian defence crowding in around him, making sure that that pass won't come out, even if the opportunity was half there. So let's see if Scotland can make this Italian defence crack. The chip tried to be put through there by Hayward. It rebounds off the feet of Italy, who drop onto that ball, and it's possession once again to the Azzurri.
Yeah, that's poor from Hayward there. They had an opportunity to build pressure, and just the kick just wasn't on. The idea was wrong, and the execution was poor as well. And Scotland piggyback Italy out of their own half here with a ill-disciplined, not getting on side with the referee, but That's a poor passage of play from the Scots. It's just compounding error with error.
Well, the last time Italy were given a penalty early in their set, they went downfield and scored from that try from Dean Paratta. They'll be keen to do the same thing one more time. So the tap is taken. And Italy try to move forward.
Give space.
Bit of a scrappy play of the ball, but clean in the end.
Okay, Coyle,
it's Jack Colavatti taking the ball through on off the bench for the Italians this afternoon. Ryan King. King last season at Whitehaven in the Championship. And here goes Brown. Brown, good ball again, keeping the ball alive. Italy moving out towards the right-hand side.
He's down in back play, Nathan Brown. That's a worrying side for the Italians. I think the referee is going to stop play and give a penalty. He was hit late off the ball. Let's have another look at this. He's a very tough human being, Nathan Brown. He doesn't stay down for no reason. I'm not so sure on that one.
It looked, yes, a little late, but relatively innocuous, yeah. I would venture.
Yeah, but you can't hit them late, so penalty it is. Yeah. And we mentioned the middle forwards of Moretti and Liara taking a well-earned rest.
Wait.
Yeah, they've certainly gone well for Italy in this first half, and that lead
and Coyle,
on the scoreboard,
out.
Well deserved as well for the Italians.
Go to.
So Paratta moving it along the line. There's Bell up and running, absolutely fine. Keeping it alive, Campagnolo. Oh, and the ball from Polselli. He looked to get it away to his winger out on the far side, Jake Mason. Just couldn't quite manage it cleanly.
That was a good shift to the left-hand side from the Italians again. Brown standing with plenty of width.
Okay, play the balls in the middle.
And Wormsley needed to knock that ball down, or it's try time. Campagnolo as well, digging into the line.
I think
it's a try save from Wormsley. If he'd managed to knock that ball up, he may have been racing down the other end of the field with an intercept, but it wasn't to be.
So it's Italy now with the ball from Santi. Santi goes forward. The defence comes in from the Scots. The ball shipped towards the centre of the field again from the Italians in the hands of Luke Hodge. Hodge goes forward.
Coyle, off that ball!
Brought down though. 5 metres out from the line. Will it be a third try of the afternoon for the Italians? It's with Brown. He keeps it moving. Campagnolo, what a ball!
Oh no, it was outstanding play from Brown and Campagnolo to set the Italians up over on that left-hand side. Another try gone begging for the Italians here.
And the pace of the passing.
Okay, move now! Here, boys!
I think it's Atkinson there. I think he could have gone himself. I don't think he needed to pass.
Dean, move!
I wonder if they will look back at that and rue that, and would it be crucial if Scotland can get some momentum in this game?
Yeah, well, it's twice now the Italians have bombed tries, the line begging. At this level of rugby league, you just can't afford to waste those opportunities. Like we say, Scotland haven't been anywhere near their best, but you've got to assume that they're going to get better as the game goes on.
Dale Ferguson, the captain, doing hard yards going forward. Schneider urging a quick play of the ball, I think just looking to see what he could get from the referee. The answer was nothing, and it's Haywood in possession for Scotland, keeping it moving out towards the right-hand side. And again, a little ball just sneaked out, and Scotland gain extra metres forward, going forward of Scotland. The Italians are there in defence. This is the last of the set. Can Scotland capitalise on this position? It's with Haywood, who look for the kick. Dinks it over the top. Kane Lynette stretches above and takes it, keeping possession of Scotland, but the Italian defence does its job. No chance of that pass coming out.
That's great work from Santi. That's absolutely great work from him to stop, to swarm the Scottish attacker there and stop the ability from offload. That's experience for you.
Brendan Santi certainly experienced two World Cups, 19 caps as well. Scored tries in the last four internationals for Italy. I'm sure he'd be keen to add to that tally today as well.
15 up.
So it's Jake Mason with the ball for the Italians, driven into the ground. As Italy try and come forward towards the halfway line. The referee just stops, a bit of an issue there in that tackle. Dan Atkinson, I think, just taking a bit of a knock. And Dean Parata just pushing away Dale Ferguson, making sure he's well aware. They'll know each other. They will have come across each other, Parata and Ferguson, numerous times in the championship, as Atkinson just gets a bit of attention. Looks like it's his ankle potentially there that's the problem. So at this point, James, both sides having a bit of time just to catch the breath with this injuries. We see Leo Epifania, the Italian coach. What, as captain of the Scots, would you be saying to these players?
Yeah, look, figure out what we're trying to do in attack. Think about what we've worked on at training, because it's just not been happening for them. Like I say, they've created a few offloads, some late offloads, but it's like they don't know what to do next. And when they do have their attack in shape, they've got to execute. A couple of times they forced passes that went on, a couple of intercepts, and I think defensively they've just got to fix up their fundamentals. Like, you go back to the try from Parata, and it's just simple stuff. Made it look far too easy, and the Italians are having far too much joy on the edge as well. So the Scots just need to reset and work their way back into this game.
So Atkinson with an ankle bandaged. The referee just calling out the captains of both sides. Telling Nathan Brown to back off while he has a word with Dale Ferguson, the referee. And for a second I thought, yep, Simbin, 10 minutes for Dale Ferguson. The way he held his hands, I thought, that's going on report, but then it was a straight 10 minutes shown by the referee. And Scotland now with a little bit of a mountain ahead of them, down to 12 men for the next 10 minutes.
Yeah, you don't want to see your captain be Simbin. It's, life's going to be very difficult for the next... Ferguson there, he puts his hand up straight away, but he studded the ankle of the Italian attacker and just invites more pressure. Italians already creating plenty of opportunities with 13 on. Now they're down to 12, the Scots. They're going to have their hands full for the next 10 minutes with the way the Italians are creating opportunities.
That's a good drive from Luke Hodge, setting up this position now for the Italians. Campagnolo keeping it moving out towards the second row of Ryan King. And Italy now with great pressure on this line and running as well with pace and intent. And brought down extremely close there. Jack Colavatti looked like it could have been the third try of the afternoon for the Italians. Now it's with Brown. Brown looks, tries to take it himself. Good defence coming in from Scotland. Kane Lynette gets to his feet after getting right around the waist of the Italian loose forward. Robinson puts a kick through, scooped up well there by Ryan Briley. And that, again, I think was a try-saver of a move from Scottish defence.
Yeah, that's a great read from Briley there. Absolutely outstanding. Team under pressure, down on troops. And he's a big-name player. That's why he steps up for this Scottish team.
So Matty Russell trying to inject a bit of pace from the wing for Scotland. As you just see again the kick coming through from Robinson, and Briley just drifting along the line and being spot on positionally to mop that one up. So Bell in the middle of the field, keeping it alive for Scotland. It doesn't feel like yet, as this is the last of the set, that The Italian defence has been hugely tested, apart from just on a couple of occasions, as Bailey Haywood kicks long downfield. That's taken nicely on the wing by Mason. And it's Italy on the attack once again. Oh, looks putting off the afterburners there, running horizontally before the tackle came in, but showing a little bit of pace there, the winger.
Yeah, this will be the last set before half-time in all probability for the Italians. Let's see if they can set some shape up and get a try just before half-time to put a real dagger in the heart of the Bravehearts.
So Italy, good, hard running coming forward.
Great carry, that. Absolutely outstanding play.
And coming from a centre as well with Ethan Natoli. A Scottish hand just getting onto that one. The referee bringing play back for the knock-on. And so this scrum probably will be the one of the last actions of this first half.
Yeah, Nathan Brown there just probably going with the wrong option as he digs the ball into the line. I'm not sure if who the ball was intended for there. I think it was supposed to go out the back to Campagnolo, but it just nudged the lead runner on the inside of that shoulder there, and a huge let off for the Italians. They'll be happy with that. They'll need to get back into half-time and have Nathan Graham address some of the issues that have been seen in this Scottish outfit in this opening 40 minutes.
So Haywood gets the ball out and away from the base of the scrum to Briley. Nice little ball there as well to his right-hand side.
He was hit hard there, Briley. He's in a bit of pain. He's limping in the backfield. I think he's going to be okay, though.
Yeah, it's waved away the physio as Walmsley. Oh, that looked a bit forward. That went out there to Lynette, but kept alive to Garn. Garn goes now, slithered right up the middle of the field. What a tackle coming in from Polselli. Garn looked like he had space opening up in front of him, but Scotland now with that momentum. Can they make it crack before half-time? Ball goes out wide. Is there a gap there for Scotland?
Oh.
It cuts loose. And that, again, a chance going begging for Scotland. How many times does it feel like we've said that in this first half? But it's been a job well done, I think, in this first 40, James, for Italy.
Yeah, and look at the scramble defence there. They were fractured through the middle of the field with some late offload. Just before half-time, the Italians turned up in defence and managed to keep out the Scottish attack, and they keep their try line intact. Brilliant scramble defence from the Italians.
Tackle five. Here comes the last. They're numbering up on this right-hand side. Wells Bear and a pass away! Oh, Young's in again!
They're a man short as well here.
Wells Bear interception! Interception! Tay goes away. I don't think they're going to catch Isaac Tago. Tompkins will do his best, but Isaac Tago. They needed a gift. They got a gift. England are going through hands. Callum Watkins has one thing on his mind, and that's to get underneath the sticks. And England stretch the lead again. Victor Radley playing in the dummy half position now. Chris Hill takes it on. England are looking for more. They want some more. It's pumped out towards Herbie Farnworth. Big muscular effort from Whitehead. Has he got in? Here comes Makinson. Gonna go on the outside. He's got the pace. They're queuing all forward pass. No, the referee says play on. The referee says play on. And Elliot Whitehead has scored again. Scored again.
You gave yourself up there. Go one.
Williams with a kick to the corner, here they go, Makinson, the latest to join the celebrations. Oh, there they go, Williams in, Williams over, England unstoppable. The World Cup charge has started here today. England with Radley. Radley spinning it left. Burgess! Burgess! Tom Burgess! How long is that list of try scorers now?
England winning that one 60 points to 6, which sees them at the top of their Group A table. France there in second. They're taking on Greece tomorrow in Doncaster. Samoa at the bottom. I have James Graham, former England and Great Britain international, alongside me. James, how important is it after that huge win for England over Samoa that they stay grounded?
Oh, yeah. Look, I could keep watching that all day, by the way. And it's important in camp. You know, it was interesting hearing Sean Wayne. Obviously, he's very diplomatic and he was pleased, but you know, he's a perfectionist, and he already addressed it. Asked straight away after the game, he was looking for ways to improve and better themselves. Those things he wasn't happy with. Now, it's hard not to be complete. It was almost a complete performance from the England team. It really was. But look, there was a challenge to come up against Samoa. Obviously, lots of household names. Samoa were favourites, and now against France and Greece, it's important that those standards now are set and they are maintained. And that comes with the week's work of practice that they did in training. It was clear as day that England would have a really intense, difficult week of training, and that showed with their level of intensity and their performance. You know, a lot gets mentioned about the tries. We see that, we love that, but it was all the little effort areas. There was a play just before half-time where Herbie Farmworth comes from the left-hand side, his centre position, all the way to the middle of field to make a try-saving tackle on Joseph Soali. It's important that England maintain these standards.
Yeah, absolutely. I just want to change our focus to here today at Kingston Park. Italy with, would you say, a surprise 12-0 lead over Scotland?
Yeah, absolutely, Jenna. The Scots would have come in as heavy favourites considering all the experience that they have, but this Italian team have been enthusiastic. They've cared for each other, one another. They've defended their line, which is the most difficult thing to do. And when they've had their opportunities in the tack, they've taken two of them. They've bombed two of them. The scoreline, I think, flatters the Scottish at the moment. But in my opinion, Italy should be further ahead had they taken those opportunities.
Yeah, absolutely. It's been a comprehensive performance by Nathan Brown there, captain. Massive second half coming our way right now.
Johnny, and of course, give it up for our winner, Camille. You've got some fans, Camille. Very, very quickly, how does it feel to win and be presenting a Player of the Match award?
Here we are, the Italian team just making their way back onto the field. They'll be delighted with the first 40 minutes of rugby league. Important they don't go away from doing what they've been doing, creating plenty of opportunities and throwing plenty of shape at the Scottish defence. The Scottish team here now, as they come out, they'll need to be better. Coach Nathan Graham will have had a stern address. I'm expecting to see a much better Scottish team performance in this second 40 minutes.
Scotland certainly having their chances in that first half, just not quite having the execution that we saw from the Italians, taking the opportunities that they had to build that 12-0 advantage going into the second half of this game. The questions then at the start of the second half is, will Italy be able to hang on or extend their lead? And will Scotland be able to get their first points of this match and get things going for their coach, Nathan Graham? It will be the Scots to kick off in this second half. And the second period is underway. Scotland, long kick downfield. Italy taking the ball cleanly, and a big hit, a sign of intent in that second half.
Yeah, that's a big sign from the Scottish team defenders there. Coming out this second half fired up, playing with plenty of aggression.
So Italy then, early stages again, just looking to settle, looking to get things going. Jack Colavatti brought to ground.
You can certainly see with the intent that the Scots have had in this opening set, defensive-wise, that there's been some stern words said at half-time, but the Italians make a break.
What a ball there to try and release Daniel Atkinson. This is the last of the set for the Italians. The ball goes back to Campagnolo, who kicks not the best of kicks. It's taken cleanly in the end by Ryan Briley for Scotland, But for a second there, it looked like Italy were going to have space just opening up in front of them.
Yeah, they just picked off a beautiful short side. It's that man Campagnolo again, who's had a great opening 40 minutes, and he's taken off again. Brilliant play from Campagnolo on this short side.
But it's Scotland with that ball. Can they also produce a moment of magic like that to try and crack the Italian defence? Matty Russell goes forward for the Scots. Again, just appealing for one or two players just to maybe get away from the play of the ball a bit quicker from some of the Scottish players as they try and find a way around with Aitken out on the edges. And now it's Walmsley going forward for Scotland. Brought down last just tackle. Inside the 40. This is the last of the set for the Scots. Schneider takes it on the short side. He's got Brierley. Brierley looks to show a dummy to Aitken. Aitken, again, tries to get that ball away to Liu. And it just goes into touch.
Yeah, it was a nice idea. Brierley picking off the short side, a double, a triple pump, holds the ball up for Aitken. But Liu on the wing there. The ball just goes behind him. Aitken sort of throws in hope, but I think even if that pass had landed, there was plenty of Italian defenders coming across in cover defence. And that's been a real highlight for me for this Italian team. Yeah, they've created opportunities, but they've taken plenty of pride in defending their line. And I think the most pleasing thing in the first 40 minutes is the fact that there's a zero against the name of the Scottish team.
The first time that the Italians have played since 2019, and it's certainly been a happy return to the field for them, I think, as well. As the ball is squeezed out again from that tackle, and Italy keep the ball alive and moving up towards the centre of the field. Oh, what a ball that one was. Well read by the Scottish defence. Again, Italians looking very sharp in the centre of the field. Atkinson with the ball, keeping it moving to Robinson. Robinson just stumbles slightly, makes the task a little easier for Bailey Hayward in defence. Campagnolo now. Kick goes through. Brierley motors his way back there and takes it, and tackled in goal as well. A good chase coming through from the Italians.
Yeah, great chase and a great kick from Campagnolo. He's been so heavily involved in this Italian attack. He's the general. He's the one that's dictating terms. He wants the ball in his hands as well as Nathan Brown. It's been a great combination between these two, but Campagnolo pulling all the strings for the Italians in attack.
Well, this afternoon's attendance has been confirmed as 6,206.
Stay behind the kick.
As the dropout comes for the Scots. Long downfield, taken nicely though by Italy. And a charge up the centre of the field coming for the Azzurri from Luke Hodge. He's made some good yards since coming off the bench, hasn't he?
Yeah, he sure has. He's worked really hard for the Italians as Hodge.
Campagnolo then. Out wide to Atkinson. Is the space here for the Italians going for the corner? It looks like it could be Mason that's in. The celebrations have started from the Italians. The referee will check it again. He will go to the screen. It looked clean from here. The video referee will have the say. Try giving on the field.
Video referee to match director with an on-field decision of try. Please can I see all available angles for grounding and touch, please? Trying to determine that the ball is down before and the man is in the field of play. Corner camera's probably going to work. Yeah, we go nice and slow here, please. He has possession of the ball. Still does. We lose the ball at that point. It looks to be down at that point. Just watch this from behind now. See the ball on that angle, I don't think. This will be the best angle. Okay, thank you. We just go nice and slow at this point, please. So he has possession of the ball. It's up there, and then we lose the ball. There, it looks as though it's down at that point, and he's in the field of play. Have we got anything else that shows the touch line at all? It certainly looks to be down. This is probably as good an angle as we'll get. We'll go back to the previous angle on after this, please. Oh, slow here, please. Slow, slow. Keep going. And pause it there, mate, please. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. I've seen all the angles I need now, and I've made my decision.
So here comes the decision from the video referee, Robert Hicks. And it's a try. Jake Mason on his debut for Italy has got them off to the best possible start in the second half and extended that lead 16-0.
Yeah, it's a great try from Mason. He's got two Scottish defenders on top of him, but again, it's that man Campagnano who throws the ball to Aikenson, and plenty of work to do for Mason there, but it's brilliant short side attack as Campagnano just starts the shift play. Like I say, that's a brilliant finish from Mason, despite the attention of two Scottish defenders there. He does his best, he gets the ball down, and the Italians are off to a flyer in this second half, continuing where they left off.
And it took some scoring as well, did that? Deserved it, I think, for the effort of hanging on to that with two defenders around him and finding the blade of grass to get it down onto as well. But a tough kick to come from Jake Campagnolo. Two from two from him so far.
And he's really taken advantage of the numerical advantage that the Italians have.
And it's looking good. It is good. Three from three, 18-0. The Italians lead. They're taking a control of this one, James.
Yeah, look, the Scottish team came out with plenty of intent in defence to start it, but they just couldn't maintain it. They're down to 12 men still for a little while longer. And the Italians just take full advantage.
Dale Ferguson still in the sin bin going off 4 minutes before that halftime hooter as Ryan Briley restarts play again straight into the arms of the Italians, who'll be gaining confidence from this performance, that first game of their World Cup. And they've looked organised, they've looked determined, and it's like you were saying as well, they've had that pride in the shirt.
Well, it's been an enthusiastic performance. You can see with their intent in their carries, their ability to chase back, and the way they're preserving their try line. That's passion, that's determination, that's care. It's been a great performance so far from this Italian team as Nathan Brown yet again carries the ball strong through the middle of the field.
Well, let's get an update from the sidelines with Jenna.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks very much, Sharon. I spoke to the Scotland head coach, Nathan Graham. Naturally, he's disappointed. He said that his side were naive with their play. Too many errors early on put them on the back foot, and they just have to smarten the ends of sets up. They must build pressure in this second half. Well, you can imagine the Italian head coach, Leo Epifania, was over the moon. He was so pleased with the way that his side defended. He gave a shout out to his captain, Nathan Brown. He said that he is playing at another level to everyone else out there, Sharon.
Team move!
Thanks, Jenna. I think probably agree with that. Nathan Brown certainly looking a different class at times with some of his play this afternoon for the Italians. But it's Scotland now in possession. Here's Lachlan Walmsley. Doesn't get far before the defence comes in.
And this is the issue now for Scotland is the scoreboard pressure aspect of this game. Do they start to force the pass instead of building their own pressure? They feel the pressure of the scoreboard. It was an important kick conversion from Campagnolo to put it to 18 points as well. So that just adds to that scoreboard pressure that the Scottish team will be feeling as this game progresses.
How much does it get inside your head as a player, though?
Well, you start to think we need to start to create something instead of kicking long, chasing hard.
As a break comes through from the Italians, this scoreboard could still be ticking over. It's Aikenson. Aikenson chased by Briley. What a tackle from the fullback from Scotland. A definite try saver there. But Aikenson now giving momentum back to the Italians again. Campagnolo along the line to Paratta. Robinson finds Santi, drives his way forward. Scotland now going from attacking to having to defend. Italy again with that possession, with that territory, as Paratta is brought down inside the Scottish tent. Again, it goes to Brown. Brown back to Campagnolo. Campagnolo along the line finds Aikenson. Will he be successful this time? He goes for the line. Held just short by Scotland. This is the last for Scotland to defend. And there again, little ball to Mason. Two from two on his debut as well. And Italy are moving this game away from the Scots now.
Have a try. Consider if you're the touchline, mate.
And again, the video referee not happy. Try given on the field. Wants to check it with the video referee.
Video referee to match director, we have an on-field decision of try. Please can I see all available angles for the touchline and grounding, please? Nice and slow here, please. Yeah, so his feet are in the field of play. Still in. Yeah, if you could just go back on that angle and just so I can see the grounding as well. Just go nice and slow at the same time. So, field of play, foots in, try. Thank you. I've seen all the angles I need. I've now made my decision. You know what that one was.
Tiptoeing down the touchline there, Jake Mason. Still waiting for the decision to come through on the big screen. But that looks like it'll be a try. And there we go, two tries in this half, both coming from the winger Jake Mason, and Italy moving forward.
Yeah, and this all comes off the back of the break from Atkinson. A beautiful play from the centre. He's had plenty of involvement. He set up a previous try as well. But this is all about Pacelli in a dummy half, fooling the Scottish defenders. As we look back at that break from Atkinson, outstanding play, it's a great tackle from Brealey. But then they shift the ball over to the right. Look at this. Oh, outstanding play from the Italian fullback there. There must have been a call from Mason to say I was unmarked. One of those calls that all teams have when you must have the ball. And that's, considering it's just his debut, it's a big call from him. A big call to demand the ball. But he finishes it off, doesn't he? And he extends this Italian lead. I think the Scots are in shell shock. Nobody expecting this. Scots coming in as heavy favourites, and perhaps they've underestimated just how enthusiastic and the quality of this Italian team.
It just goes to show that without that warm-up, Italy haven't come into this one cold at all, as the kick comes through again from Campagnolo and just takes the paint off the upright on the outside. So his first miss, I think, of the afternoon there. But 22 points to nil, James. Like you say, I don't think anybody really would have predicted this.
No, absolutely not. And, you know, give the credit to the Italians to the way they've approached this game. It's just been enthusiastic. They've wanted it more than what the Scottish team have. That's what it comes down to. It's that desire. They want this victory.
So the kickoff comes relatively short, but still taken by the Italians. Scotland just looking to mix things up a bit there, as we see a very serious-looking Nathan Graham.
Yeah, look, I'm not sure if James Bell collects...
It's Brendan Santi that's down.
I'm not sure if he collects Santi high there or not, but one of the Italian players wasn't happy with James Bell's area of contact. Yeah, he makes contact with the head, and it's got intent in it as well. I'd be surprised to see Bell remain on the field after that.
Does he lead a little with the shoulder as well?
Well, it's not so much that he's led with the shoulder, it's just where he's made contact. But the referee doesn't appear to be taking any action. That's a surprise for me. Bell can consider himself lucky to minimum not be penalised as he flies out the line again. It's a sign of frustration from the Scots. That's all that is. It's a sign of frustration. And then this is important now, where Italy don't get bogged down into the argy-bargy, the push and shove and the niggle. They've just got to keep doing what they've been doing and play with class.
So Atkinson with possession for Italy. He's certainly made his impact in this second half as the Italian centre, as a little bit of a juggle just comes through there as well. But Italy hanging on to that possession safely.
That's Brown's 19th run of the afternoon.
He's been incredible for me, for the Italians, this afternoon, as a kick is high and taken by Lachlan Walmsley. Tackled nicely by Mays and watched by the Italian winger.
Great defence from the Italians.
Yeah, he took the words out of my mouth. What a drive. Again, that man involved in there, Nathan Brown, and again, he's there or thereabouts as Lachlan Walmsley tries to take the ball for Scotland.
They just look a little bit lost, the Scots here. They look a little bit lost. They don't quite know what to do. Everything that they've tried so far in this game hasn't really worked for them. Other than, you know, very early in the piece.
Oh, as we've got a break here. A good ball just releasing. I think it was Brierley. that got that ball. It wasn't. Apologies to Briley. But Scotland with the possession. Looking lively. Now it is Briley with ball in hand. Giving it to Ben Helliwell on off the bench. He kicks from the outside of the foot. Hacked forward by Aitken. And it's Italy that come up with that possession. Scotland just looked like they were trying something a bit different there.
Yeah, but, you know, off the back of that break, I'd like to see them do a little bit more, fall into some shape or really flood the middle and attack that ruck. They just look a little bit lost and out of ideas, to be honest. And, you know, again, credit to the Italians. The play, they make the break, everybody's back onside, and then the kick comes. It's an unethical, it's a, you know, an unpredictable kick. But then they've got numbers in the picture. So they stack the odds in their favour to collect a bobbling ball. It's great, great work and great work ethic for the Italian team.
So the defence comes in from Scotland. Ben Helliwell involved that. And getting to his feet, it's Hodge. Italy coming on the short side for the kick. Briley's underneath it, watches it come down. Pressure coming in from the defence.
Get up, Luke!
But in the end, it's Bailey Hayward that takes it clearly for Scotland. Lachlan Walmsley again coming in off the wing. Great work by the Italians. They're looking so strong, even in the tackle now, as they have done all match. But just at this stage of the game, they're still looking to just push the player back when they get in there with that contact.
Yeah, they're winning the energy battle of this game, no doubt about it. And they're just starting to turn the screws and bring out the frustration in the Scots with all the energy that the Italians have, both with and without the ball. We saw there Palessi chasing down a kick, putting pressure on Briley at the back there. This is the type of things that you do when you're winning that energy battle.
So the set restart given to the Scots, who again coming attacking on the short side. Aitken there having a bit of a battle trying to go forward, and he gains an extra few metres for his trouble as well. Oh, and the offload, he comes. I think he was convinced it was a Scottish player that was on his right-hand side there. And it was Atkinson who gratefully took that.
Yeah, I'm not too sure whether Atkinson called for that ball. Bit of gamesmanship, perhaps, but it was a great carry from Ewan Aitken, a former teammate of mine. But he, again, that's that scoreboard pressure that I speak about in the right context. Ewan Aitken holds that ball, plays the ball, and thinks about the next play. But because he realises Scotland need to score, they're desperate to score, he forces that pass when perhaps it was none.
If I'd have been in Dan Atkinson's boots, I think I'd have called for it and pushed my luck, to be quite honest. So Brown again for the Italians. Oh, great break, and he's got support as well. Half a gap, and it's exploited by Nathan Brown, and that sets Italy up quite nicely again. This is the last of the set. What can they do with it? Paratta along the line to Robinson, who puts that grubber kick through as he held back as Scotland shepherd that ball over the dead ball line to force the dropout.
I've been impressed with the short kicking game of Robinson. We saw him set up a try earlier in the piece to start the scoring off for the Italians, and that's really cool, calm, collected play there. He steps off his right, sees us as an opportunity to not score, but turn that pressure game up again and just build that pressure. Great work from Robinson.
As you mentioned, a late call-up into the Italian squad as the dropout is short, still taken, though, safely by Italy. And this, again, could put them into a decent position, a decent chance, as Santi drives his legs, tries to get those legs pumping forward. Takes play to within 20 metres of the Scottish line. Colavati for Italy. Scotland just trying to get back, trying to organise themselves on that whitewash in defence. Robinson again. The ball goes high. It pops up from, I think, a Scottish hand. Either way, Scotland in the end taking it nicely from Matty Russell. And six again. Set restarts indicated by the referee.
Yeah, the Italians got that one wrong. I thought they should have come to their left-hand side. Nathan Brown, their go-to man, was set up playing with width. He's been working for them coming to this left edge all afternoon and all early evening. Oh, as the Scots make another error coming out of trouble. They just can't get a thing right today, the Scottish outfit.
And it's the captain, Dale Ferguson, berating himself. I think there you can see him having a bit of a chunter and a bit of a moan to himself for not getting that clean. And a play with experience, as has Dale Ferguson. That's a little bit of a basic error. I understand why he's so annoyed with himself.
Yeah, he's used some choice words as well there. Thankfully, he's not mic'd up for our listeners. But, a real sign of frustration coming out from the Scots. It's just not been their afternoon, has it?
And I always think it's a sign as well when you see the coach like Nathan Graham coming down to the touchline as well from his position in the stand. I always think when a coach comes down from the stand to the touchline, they mean business. There's something that's got to change by that point.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree with you 100% there. And yeah, they've really disappointed. But you know what? Funny things happen in rugby league and there's still 23 minutes to play. I think the Scots just need a score. Give them some form of hope. And then, you know, I use this word a lot about pressure that then starts to put a bit of doubt in the mind of the Italians. Have we got it? We haven't had that warm-up game. All those little things. But for the moment, here come Italy all again.
On the attack, Ryan King with the first carry of the set brought down. Hodge. Again, valuable metres. Just a few men extra forward for the Italians. Now back on the field is Iaria.
We're here! Come on, get up!
Forwards doing the work early in this tackle count for the Italians. And here's that man again, Nathan Brown, keeping it moving along the line. Looking good again, Ryan King. King shrugs off one tackle, can't get away from the next two defenders that come in from Scotland. As Atkinson sends the ball back infield. Brown again, looks like he was going to take it himself, didn't in the end.
Last tackle release! Come on,
and
get
this
up.
Is the last of the set again for the Italians. Fifth of the set of six. Ferrata along the line. Finds Robinson. Puts that little grubber kick through again. Shepherded away once more by Scotland. And again, the dropout's forced.
Again, great short kick from Robinson. He's been doing this all evening. And I've just got to compliment the Italians. Considering the fact that they haven't been together very long, they're attacking shape. It's almost perfect. We saw that move to the left-hand side there. They didn't get the desired outcome on get a try, but they're asking plenty of questions of the Scottish defence. You do that enough, and like we've seen, you will get points.
Very short dropout coming from Bailey Haywood, and it's not come off. The ball is knocked on. Again, Scotland looking to do something different, but Bailey Haywood just not quite pulling it off.
Yeah, captain's challenge.
Okay, captain's challenge.
So the screen will be gone to. It's Ben Thaler, the referee for the captain's challenge.
Video referee to match director, I'm looking for your best angle, including the ball, to determine the knock-on at the pickup, please. Ball has gone 10. Trying to determine who knocked on first here then, to see whose hands are on the ball. As we look at that angle, it's the first angle that's probably the best one to look at, please, determining who gets the ball first. So if we go slow on this, please. So to both players, go towards the ball. Yeah, it's by Italy first. Based on the available angles, this decision is a knock-on, challenge unsuccessful.
Okay, the challenge is unsuccessful, top Italy.
And the challenge is unsuccessful, which means that is the captain's challenge from Scotland unsuccessful. They've not got any more challenges, is the point I'm trying to make. That's it. You get one chance. If it's successful, it could get another chance. As soon as you fail with that challenge, you lose your challenges. So it's Scotland with the head and feet. It must have been the Italians' challenge, wasn't it? Sorry.
I was just thinking,
Italians. And a penalty now awarded to Scotland.
Okay, well, this is it now for Scotland. They've got a penalty coming out of trouble. They managed to get the ball back off the short dropout. Still 20 minutes left to play, 21 minutes left to play. You've still got time to make a game of this.
So Bailey Haywood with the kick for touch. That'll earn Scotland some good yardage upfield.
Yeah, now they've just got to take a couple of carries forward, get to a point on the field and throw some shape at this Italian defence.
Let's see what they can do with it. Kane Lynette going forward for Scotland. He's been a little quieter, as Kane Lynette, than I expected this afternoon.
Yeah, he's considering all his experience, he hasn't had the impact that you know Nathan Graham would have liked, I imagine.
Six again, slow. He's got to.
Six caps to his name. Set restart is indicated by the referee as Billy Haywood goes to ground for the Scots. And it's Schneider at acting half along to James Bell. keeps it moving. Luke Bain going forward for Scotland. Again, we see Scotland trying to build a good position in decent territory. What can they do with it? What will the execution be like? Garn with the ball to his left-hand side to Luke.
He was hit late there.
It's Lynette that took the hit.
I'm not much sure. I think it might have been Garn. He was taken sort of without the butt.
Yeah,
it's Brown. Heavy contact from Brown. Okay, again, this is where Scotland need to lay a point. Throw some shape, ask some questions of the Italian defence. They're young, inexperienced Italian defence.
And Scotland are certainly in a decent position as far as that territory goes now, 10 metres away. We've seen them here two or three times in this match so far. Still to get that scoreboard to crack. Haywood, the crowd gets behind them. Long ball out wide to Wormsley. Wormsley stretches and leaps and takes it. He's caught by Mason.
Great scramble. Great scramble defence from the Italians there.
And it's a set restart as well. The penalty awarded to Scotland. Another infringement from Italy. And this surely will just add to a little bit of momentum for Scotland as Halliwell goes forward.
Move! Enemy hole!
They really just need to find something a little bit more inventive, I think, so close to the line. Here's Dale Ferguson. Ferguson, good strength from him. He looks to get that ball out, tries to promote it away from the tackle, but plenty of Italian defenders in there around him. It goes back again to Haywood. Haywood keeps it moving to Briley. Nice step coming in from the fullback. Again, brought down. Not too much penetration through that Italian defence yet from the Scots. And that, again, a little bit of a wasted attempt, I think, coming in there from Scotland. Nothing really gained at all from that particular carry. So they give it air and move it out wide, back towards the centre of the field. James Bell comes back inside. He finds Aitken. Aitken dances in the face of the blue shirts that come up to him. And Scotland have lost ground as a result. He tries to go forward once more and again takes play back to that 10-metre line. Scotland, I don't think, have basically gained anything from this particular set, and this is the last for them. Bailey Haywood, what can they do with it? Kick goes over the top into space. It's is that a try? Has Haywood followed that up? No, the referee right on the spot for it. I think Haywood thought he was in with a chance, and I think certainly the crowd went with it as well, but in the end, it's just the handover.
Yeah, it took them to the last play to even look like scoring there. The Scottish team, they moved the ball to this right-hand side. Briley tackled with the ball, and then they didn't know what to do next. And what really, at this standard of international football, you should have enough knowledge and football IQ to be able to go shot for shot. So you take your run into the one side, or your halfback gets tackled with the football. And then the other remaining spine players should fall into shape. And just unfortunately for the Scots, we've not seen that all afternoon.
We're here, hold.
Bailey Haywood has tried to be a little more inventive, I think, probably than some of his teammates. But overall, if you're going to compare halfbacks for halfbacks, the Italians have certainly been the better pairing, I think, this afternoon.
Oh, absolutely. No doubt about it. Robinson with his game organisation, short kicking game, and then some pieces of brilliance from Campagnolo. He's been outstanding as far as I'm concerned for the Italians today. Here he is with another high hanging kick.
Underneath it is Wormsley, clearly called for that. You could see Ryan Briley just retreating as that ball started to come down. And Matty Russell goes forward on. You could see that was loose as he went there in the tackle as the pressure came in. And look what it means to the Italians.
Yep, you can really see what that means. A huge play from them. Russell, I'm not sure if he's looking to offload the football there or get up and remain running. But again, it's been the story of Scotland's day, hasn't it? Unforced errors.
And Nathan Graham looking ever more pensive on that touchline, the Scotland coach. Not been a happy afternoon for him and his players to get their World Cup campaign up and running this afternoon. It's certainly been Italy that will take the headlines from this. But we have still got another 15, 20 minutes still remaining of this half for them. Scotland to regain a little bit of pride from this one as Italy go forward again. Still in there with that defensive work. Three Scots retreat as the ball is played to Parata along the line. Driving forward again.
Get up!
Are Italy to take play to just outside the 10 in the Scottish half of the field. As Parata keeping it moving again. Robinson involved to Santi.
Let's go, let him up! 1 point!
Putting pressure on once more, and I think it's a knock-on, the referee says.
Yeah, Santi, the experienced man there, just coming up with an error. But if there's a place you are going to make errors, it's at this point in the field, down on the opposition try line.
So the two sides coming to pack down, 10 metres out from that Scottish line. And work to do, really, from Scotland. They've struggled, as you've said, James, when they've got near that Italian line to crack that defence, to finally crack that defence. They've got work to do when they are so far down the field. We've not seen the sort of clean breaks, the little bit of spark that we've seen from the Italian attack. It's just not been there for Scotland.
No, you're right. It really hasn't. It really hasn't.
Hold! Luke!
So it's the Bravehearts again, and coming up with the error. Kieran Buchanan not taking that ball, giving it Italy possession back, gifting Italy it.
Yeah, it's almost a bit of deja vu, isn't it, with some of these silly errors that we're seeing from the Scottish team. It's just not been their day, and they compound errors with more errors and mistakes. It just played into the hands of the Italians. It really, really has. There'll be some soul searching going on in the Scottish camp in the next couple of days. They've been really disappointing so far. That said, the Italians have came here to Newcastle full of enthusiasm, and you've got to give them plenty of credit for what they've done. They have been gifted a few opportunities and some field position, but take nothing away from what they've managed to do. Campagnolo especially, Nathan Brown and the rest of his troops, they've been fantastic.
So Brendan Santi, I'm sure Italy will be keen to keep this scoreboard moving. Still time to go in this game. 22-0 their lead. The ball goes to Nathan Brown. Nice ball almost taken from behind there by Luca Moretti. Before the tackle comes in. Now it's Parata. Parata offloads. Centre of the field. Italy again going close. Scotland doing tremendous work there in defence. Keeping the player back. Pushing him back. Making sure there's no further tries yet from the Italians, who move the ball out towards wide, their right-hand side. That's a good tackle coming in there from Scotland. Matty Russell right in there, making sure that the player couldn't get that ball out and wasn't going to get any further metres forward either. The kick comes over the top from Robinson. Wormsley is there, takes it safely behind his own post and goes to get ready for the tap on the 20 to restart.
Yeah, finally he gets one wrong, Robinson.
Kieran Hall.
To Scotland from Hayward in the middle of the field once more to Lynette. The Hull KR player gets to his feet, plays it on the 40. Scotland gaining a few more extra metres. What are you making of that shape? Just looking at that line from Scotland, it just looks a little ragged to me.
Yeah, it's not the traditional shapes. Obviously a 7-tackle set, restart. Oh, brilliant hands.
Ryan Brown, what skill from the Scots. Incredible, just to keep the possession. Kicks, flicks and tricks.
I think that's the highlight of the Scottish attack all afternoon.
This is the last of the set. Briley, almost a magician on that occasion with a high kick, this time taken safely by Paul Selly under extreme pressure from the Scottish defence. But yeah, that was from an error. What a highlight that was for Scotland.
It really was.
Move!
So Italy then, once again, with that ball on their own try line, what can they do with it? We talk about the magic there from the Scots, who've seen a little bit of glimpses of magic as this afternoon's gone from the Italians. We just look again from Ryan Barile's juggle. Ben Helliwell's back kick and flick and taken by Lachlan Wormsley on the wing. Incredible. It was like an episode of Strictly Come Dancing or Dancing with the Stars, wasn't it? So once again, Italy trying to bring play clear. This is the last of their set, though. Scotland done well on this occasion to keep Italy back inside their own 40.
Yeah, they're just looking slightly tired there, aren't they, the Italians? Lots of hands on hips and slunching over. That's the fatigue factor. But a good clearing kick from Campagnolo.
As Wormsley gets a clatter for his troubles. For taking that ball on the fly. Bailey Hayward to Matty Russell. Gets around one defender, attacks the line again. Good work. Joey Tramontana on off the bench now for the Italians. He'll take his place at hooker. James Bell to Lynette. Lynette a little bit more involved. Since I said I've not been too impressed with what I've seen from him, he's got a bit more involved.
The commentator's case strikes again.
There's Bell. Oh, great ball to Luckley. Luckley goes up the centre of the field. If he wasn't a prop forward, I think he'd have his chances fancied. But keeping the ball alive to Briley with the kick over the top. Can Briley get it away? He can't. The defence does a great job there.
And that's what it means. Four Italian players in the picture off the back of the break. I mentioned a minute ago about the fatigue factor setting in for the Italians. Hands on hips, looking tired. But look at this, the break from the prop forward, the scramble back from the Italians is the highlight here as Briley leaps for chip in a chase. And there's one, two, three, four Italian jerseys in the picture. That is outstanding stuff from the Italian defence there. That's what this try line and that zero means to them.
So the ball goes dead. One of the Italian players just receiving a bit of attention at the back of play. It's Nathan Brown.
I think it might be time for him to come off for a rest. Yeah, the trainer just signalling the rolling arm. Don't worry, he's not dancing. He's saying come off the field. And Nathan Brown has worked tirelessly. 70-minute performance, 24 carries, 129 metres and 33 tackles. He's been outstanding. Italy's leading metre maker, minus Atkinson, who's ran for 215 metres after a couple of really neat line breaks. Outstanding performance from the Italian captain. And he's staying out there. He's waved away the trainer's call. And he's doing it for his cause. That's what it means to him to remain out there and play for Italy.
Yeah, he's spoken about his pride, his... ancestry, the Scottish ancestry, the Italian ancestry on his mum's side as Scotland going forward now with that ball. Getting possession, of course, from that dropout. Hayward to Bell. Steps off one foot, changes direction, back to Luckley. Drives at that line. Good work there from the Scottish prop forward. Again, Italy there in numbers with the tackle. Here's Bell. Again, a bit of a skip. Every time he gets it, there's the skip. It goes to Aitken. Aitken brought down 10 metres away from the Italian line, which feels so many times that that's as far as Scotland get because of the work that Italy are doing in defence. As again, Bell with ball in hand in the centre of the field. It goes out to Lynette.
Last tackle!
This will be the last of the set. Scotland going on the short side, looking for fast hands. Italy, though, just get in there. The numbers get in there, mess up the play. And again, Scotland have a chance that goes begging.
Yeah, again, the short side raid. I'm not too sure if that was the right option from the Scots. Italy have got plenty of numbers in the picture there. Pulselli running across in cover defence also.
So it'll be Scotland with another chance on that line. The runner coming through from Bayliss Brown. Hood back on the field. Scotland keeping it moving out towards the left-hand side. Oh, great effort coming in defence again there from the Italians, and a knock-on's forced.
And again, we see what it means to them. Nine Italian players congratulating one another about keeping this Scottish attack out. It's Robinson one-on-one with Kane Lynette, who forces the error there. Lynette just tries to go into that space that is left from the jamming defence, but unfortunately for him, he can't maintain the hold on the football. And yet again, another error. Very, very costly. They've paid the price for the amount of mistakes that they've made with the ball in hand.
I think a penny for Nathan Graham's thoughts at this point. As, oh, here we go again with Mears, and he's on for his hat-trick.
See ya.
Going right down the field. Nobody's going to catch Mason. And he gets his third try of this half, the third try of the game. A hat-trick on his debut for Italy.
What a way to make your international debut with a hat-trick of tries. This is sensational stuff. We talk about the effort in defence. They've been doing it for about the last 5 minutes. They finally get the ball back, and it's amazing with his third try of the afternoon, a clear breakaway try. What a performance it's been from him.
the Sunshine Coast Falcons player, 25-year-old Australian, representing his heritage this afternoon. And he saw the gap and he went for it.
Look, it's pretty soft, that defence, but take nothing away from Mason there. There's still plenty of work to do. And when you've got speed like that, you can't afford to be soft and then give the player like that gaps to run into. Poor defence, but Mason, wow, what a game he's had. He'll remember this day for the rest of his life. His Italian debut, and he comes away with a hat-trick. Normally, when people get a hat-trick, they're assuming for man of the match or player of the match. Not giving anything away. I don't think he's going to get it, though.
I'll be asking you that in a couple of minutes' time. Let's just see how the kick gets on. First from Jake Campagnolo with the attempt at the conversion. But Italy this afternoon, and certainly in this second half, have looked the better side. And they've certainly built a lead that they've deserved as this game has gone on. So Campagnolo then with the attempt. 3 from 4 so far. Can he make it 4 from 5? Jake Campagnolo then with the attempt to add the conversion on his 4th appearance in an Italian shirt. Plays for South Sydney. The referee just getting time started again. And the extra 2 go in, 28-0. Italy have that lead. And while we're waiting, I think there, James, just to see this try again, I will ask you to have a bit of a think about the man of the match as we see Mason's break again.
Yeah, sensational stuff, isn't it? Clean pair of heels from Mays for his hat-trick. A good variety of tries from the Italian wingman.
And Leo Epifania, as well as the fans, delighted with that. As Scotland kick off with Ryan Briley, relatively short. Oh, taken beautifully as well by Buchanan for Scotland. And the Scots have the possession. We'll come on to the man of the match in just a second. Let's see if Scotland can capitalise on this. Set restart was cleared by the referee. Good drive forward by the Scots. Once again, Hood adapting half. Little ball to Lynette. Lynette tries to stretch his way out. He's tall, but he's not that tall. Still a bit of daylight between him and that whitewash. Here goes Hood. Hood scrambles his way back, eventually gets the ball to Bell, who shows it, loses a bit of ground before offloading to Aitken. Aitken goes running at the angle. Great ball there to Wormsley. Wormsley's in. And finally, Scotland get themselves on the scoreboard. Lachlan Wormsley, the winger, gets the try for Scotland.
Yeah, finally, the Scots break the duck. It's a beautiful ball from Aitken. Too little, too late, though, for the Scots. The Italians will be really disappointed with that. It was a great short kickoff, but you know, you can see the pride that they've had in their try line all afternoon. But take nothing away from this man, Lachlan Wormsley. He can find his way to the try line, and there's still a fair bit to do after the beautiful flick pass from Aitken. Look at this, Aitken on the outside of his man. Flick ball. A nice, tidy finish from Wormsley.
Lachlan Wormsley scoring 28 tries from 22 appearances for Halifax in the championship this season. He knows how to find that try line, and he's finally managed it this afternoon as well. So Ryan Briley with his first attempt at goal this afternoon, and that just goes across the face of the post. So 28-4 is the scoreline. And while we can catch our breath after those back-to-back tries, James, let me just ask you, who's your man of the match basically this afternoon?
Yeah, look, there's lots of contenders. Obviously, the Italians have completely blown the Scots off the park. You know, lots of contributions. Campagnolo has been sensational. Robinson as well, his halves partner, has been good. Moretti had a great start to the game. You know, Mason with a hat-trick. Usually when someone gets a hat-trick, they're a shoo-in for man of the match. Aitkinson as well, 215 metres. But there's only one person, as far as I'm concerned, that deserves the man of the match more than anybody, and that's Nathan Brown. He's been a fantastic contributor to the Italian cause. He's led from the front, Lots of beautiful touches, 23 runs, 129 metres, 34 tackles. It's been so workmanlike. An 80-minute performance also. I believe he is... Is he still out there or not? Yeah, I think he's come off the field and taken a well-earned rest, and that's why Nathan Brown is my Kazu man of the match.
Deserved. We heard from Jenna that coach Leo Epifania had said that he'd looked a class apart at times this afternoon, and he certainly had, and I think a deserved award for the Italian captain this afternoon.
Release the grip.
So it's Scotland then with the ball. Here goes Hood attacking that line. Bit of a mazy run coming from the Wakefield hooker to Bell. Haywood to Aitken. Little ball just popped up to Helliwell. Helliwell to Luckley. Luckley goes forward, met by Santi. Santi does enough while his teammates come in to help out with that tackle. Yaria getting stuck in there as well. This is the last of the set. Here's James Bell going forward. Oh, and that will just die in that tackle unless he can keep it alive. It goes into the hands anyway of the Italian, but the referee, I think, had already called that one, and so it's just the handover.
Yeah, probably not the right time to be taking that sort of run on the last tackle from Bell.
Play the ball. Good tackles. Move now, off that up! Wait!
Italy then trying to drive the way out of their own 20. Tramontana with the ball towards the right-hand side.
James,
Italy still trying to bring the play up the centre of the field. The next games, incidentally, for these two, Scotland have a tough one against Australia on Friday night, whereas Italy next in action back here in Newcastle. They take on Fiji, and that'll be an interesting one on the back of the performances we've seen this weekend as Italy keep the try, trying to keep the ball alive out on their far side. This is the last of the set for Italy. Tramontana to Robinson with the kick. Wormsley's underneath it, takes it safely. Just a little bit of a skid as he goes in there, and that defensive line meets him.
Yeah, talking about that game next week, Scotland are going to have their work cut out against the Australians, but wow, the Fiji against Italy game, that's going to determine who advances to the quarterfinals as far as I'm concerned, and unless there's absolute miracles happening these next couple of weeks. That game is going to determine who plays quarterfinal World Cup Rugby League.
Well, both coaches said this afternoon was a must-win, and it's the Italians that have come up with that win, given themselves a good chance of trying to progress from this Group B. With this win this afternoon against Scotland, they have dominated the Scottish. It's shown on the scoreboard with that 28-4 victory from Italy.
The final score in this rugby league. And he puts his hand up and apologised straight away, but you know he can have no complaints, and neither can anyone else for him being removed for 10 minutes. And I think during that time that the Italians scored two tries, so they did pay a big price for that.
In the second half, we saw Scotland come out with, it looked like, a bit more oomph to their game, a bit more impetus to their game as well, a little bit more sharpness and effort, but it didn't last long, did it? Italy soon snuffed that out.
Yeah, absolutely. They came out of the dressing rooms at halftime with the real intent with their defense and played with plenty of aggression, but it just wasn't enough. And yeah, the Italians took full advantage of having an extra man on the field.
See pictures there of Brendan Santi speaking to James Bell. Many of these players will know each other, having played against each other, whether that be in Australian competitions or certainly in English competitions. Both sides coming together, not many games together before this afternoon, but Italy certainly having that advantage. Let's hear from that man of the match this afternoon. Down pitch side with Jenna is Nathan Brown.
Yeah, thanks very much, Sharon. I have Nathan Brown, the Italian captain, alongside me as he puts his Kazoo Player of the Match medal on. Congratulations, that was a huge win. It was a must-win game. Italy won. So what does that do for your aspirations?
Yeah, it gives us enormous confidence, and yeah, just really proud of the boys. You know, it's been a good week in camp, and you know, we've got a lot of players that are part-time, but I just try to do my best and help them out as much as I can, and you know, really good kids, and you know, I'm just really proud of them.
Well, you certainly did do your best. You were instrumental. I want to talk about you. I want to talk about your teammates and just how much you wanted that win today.
Yeah, we knew that, you know, everyone, you know, pretty much read us off this whole tournament. And, you know, that's what us Italians are about. You know, we're just about hard work and passion and, you know, we'll fight it to the death. So that's pretty much all our... all we were talking about during the week is just, you know, fight for the full 80 minutes. And, yeah, I'm just really proud of the boys. You know, it's obviously a pleasure being captain of Italy. And, yeah, I'm just really stoked with how they turned up.
And how you turned up as well. What can this team achieve this year?
Look, we're just going to go game by game, you know. You know, that's one off the list. And, you know, obviously we're in a tough pool. But, like I said before, we... all we know is, us Italians, all we know is to fight and, yeah, we're just trying to fight for each 80 minutes performance.
About 10 minutes to go, you did go down. You look like you're in a little bit of pain. Are you okay?
Yeah, all good. I'm not used to playing on this kind of surfaces, to be honest. First time playing here and, it's all good.
Well, congratulations. You are the Kazoo player of the match, Nathan Brown. Go get him.
Yeah, thank you.
Leading by a captain's example this afternoon, the man of the match, Nathan Brown, as we see the Italians on the field celebrating. And certainly a performance to celebrate, certainly at this stage. One game down, job done, James Graham.
Yeah, absolutely. They couldn't have asked for anything more. I think the coach and all the staff will be delighted with, you know, the real effort areas, the care factor, their dedication to keeping the opposition to zero, which they managed to do up until the dying moments of this game. So really, really good performance from the Italians and a great start to this competition from them.
Well, let's go back down now to pitch side. She is with the Italian coach, Leo Epifania.
He is with me, Sharon. Congratulations. Are you sure that was Italy's first hit out?
Definite. It was their first hit out. I think that we've done a lot of gelling, though. You know, we've been at this for a few years, so I think the boys showed that they had bonded quite well and were never going to let each other down out there. They played that way.
What was the best thing about that win?
I'm just happy for the boys. Really wanted that performance, and I just feel good for them that they were able to experience it. We've done a lot of talking up till now, but as everyone knows, it comes down to the actual match itself, and you've got to come up with the talk stops at some point. But they did what they spoke about, so I'm really happy that we were able to do a lot of what we spoke about over the last few weeks.
And no doubt one of the players leading that talk was your captain, Nathan Brown. Just how instrumental is he?
He's a champion person. I love him. He was a big part of us pulling this together. He gelled us. Great leader. Couldn't have asked, wouldn't swap him for anyone, and couldn't have asked for anything else out of him, any more out of him.
And no doubt attention will turn to Saturday's game against Fiji. If you win that, you are through to the knockout stages for the first time in Italy's history.
Well, that would be great, but as I said, we didn't come here to lose any games. I understand we're up against, I'm not delusional, we're up against some tough opposition, but you know, with efforts like that and the boys, their efforts out there is enough to keep us in the game. We've got a few things that we need to fix up. There's a lot of penalties that we gave away. We can't be doing that with Fiji, but the plan is same as next week.
Same again, Leo Epifania. Congratulations. That was a big win today. Thank you.
Thank you.
We'll bring in the Scotland head coach now, Nathan Graham. Nathan, are you surprised by what happened out there today?
No, not at all. Italy have got a good group going there. Leo's prepped them really well and probably taught us a little bit of a lesson there.
You did say before this game that your biggest challenge was the unknown of Italy. What do you know about them now?
Yeah, well, obviously they're a quality outfit. We have known that from the start. And they probably taught us a little lesson in how to play in regards to building pressure and completing sets and executing the plays. And I thought that we were pretty off with our execution. And, you know, we coughed up a load of errors, which kept putting us under pressure.
What do you put the number of errors down to? Nerves?
No, I just think a few loose carries, a few forced offloads that didn't go to hand, which we could have just gone down and played the ball quickly and got them on the next play. You know, and that's down to decision making, which we need to fix up.
So how do you pick them up after this defeat?
Yeah, we've got two big games coming up, Australia next and then Fiji. So obviously massive opposition for our guys, and I'm sure they'll be raring to play against them.
Well, Nathan Graham, thank you so much for talking to us today. We really appreciate it.
No worries. Cheers, Jenny. Thanks.
A disappointed Scotland coach, Nathan Graham. Work for him to do ahead of their next game against Scotland in Coventry on Friday night. But this afternoon, certainly Italy grabbing the headlines. 28-4, the final scoreline. And a comprehensive win as well, I think, from that performance from the Italian. Let's see if we can see the tries from the second half. And James Graham, it was really just one man all the way.
Yeah, it sure was. Look, this is fantastic stuff from Campagnolo to get the ball out wide, and a beautiful finish from Mason. That's one of his tries that he scored in his hat trick on debut, and it speaks to that desire that we spoke about in the piece and wanting it a little bit more. It was interesting to hear from Scotland coach Nathan Graham there, focus on some of the errors. But for me, the most compelling thing was the fact that I think the Italians just wanted it that little bit more more than the Scottish team, which for me is a big concern, as we see Mason go over there for I think his second of the afternoon. And this is a beautiful little overcall. It's a great ball from Pacelli in at dummy half, but you've got to be brave when you make that call to get the ball on your own try line in a situation like that. You've got to back yourself, and that's what Mason did there. Here we are, his second of the try. This is a beautiful individual try, just a couple of passes strung together, and once he's in space, absolutely see you later. There's no one getting anywhere near him, and he rounds off an absolute magnificent debut, a day and a moment he'll remember for the rest of his life.
He saw the gap, he pinned his ears back and he went.
Yeah, showing a clean pair of heels, the tongue out in celebration. He knows no one's getting anywhere near him there. And what a day, what a moment for this youngster. This is Scotland's only try of the evening. It took them a long time to get there. Ewan Aitken playing in the back row, but he started out as a centre, and we see why there. It's a nice little foot flick pass to the try-scoring machine in Walmsley. It's a pity that couldn't have come a little earlier in the piece and made more of a contest of this game. But take nothing away from the Italians. They came here to play. They were determined, they were passionate, and they just really wanted the victory. You could see that with their little effort areas that they kept bringing and kept delivering for the full 80 minutes.
So Leo Epifania, a happy head coach this afternoon. That looked almost a grimace, didn't it? But Leo Epifania, a happy coach, taking his side into their next game, which is next Sunday back here in Newcastle against Fiji. And just looking at the table, that win this afternoon taking Italy into second place behind Australia. And certainly Scotland with a tough match next week against Australia, meaning that it's likely that Fiji against Italy will be the battle for second place in this group to see who will be going through to the knockout stages with Australia. Plenty of rugby to come before then, but Italy, James, what a start from then.
Yeah, they couldn't have asked for anything more, could they? In all areas of the game, yeah, it wasn't absolutely perfect, but having said that, they turned up determined to play, and they just need for the rest of the tournament, if they can play like that, they're going to give themselves a red-hot crack. Australia will be difficult, undoubtedly, no matter who they come up against. They're the best players in the world and the best team in the world, and rightly so. But this Italian team, if they can play like that against Fiji, if they can replicate exactly what they did in this 80-minute performance today, they've given themselves a red-hot crack against a pretty high-quality Fiji team as well. But it's going to be around doing the same things that they did today and a big reliance on their captain, their inspirational leader, Nathan Brown. He was sensational today. He had his fingerprints all over this result. And, you know, we focus on the work areas, high work rate, but he's got some beautiful touches with ball in hand as well, playing inside, playing outside, playing out the back. He's a joy to watch.